and more practices around the world are starting to think that billing by the billable hour does not make any economic sense any longer. The reason for this is that there are different ways to price your services, and that value pricing, for example, might be a better way to align the interests of your client with the interests of your practice, while avoiding commoditizing your services. The concept of value pricing is based on pricing according to the value which the service you extended to the client represents to the client itself, and not billing according to the hour or according to historical habits and historical pricing habits. This clearly can make a big difference in the way we operate with our clients and in the way we put value on our services, and also on the degree of satisfaction that our clients have when they receive our service and when they pay for our services. Ron Baker, who is the founder of the Verisage Institute and is a very popular business writer in the US, and also is one of the most famous advocates of value pricing, has kindly accepted the invitation of the S&P Committee of IFAC to write a three-part series of articles for our website. These articles are based on his best-selling books on value pricing. He has just published the sixth in a row, and all of them make a great reading for SMPs all around the world. Marketing is also key to the success of an SMP, but speaking of marketing in modern times means a lot of different things, and especially marketing nowadays means having a web presence, a web profile, and of course a website, which is already something coming from the old times. But marketing also means nowadays having a presence in the social media community. This can really make a difference. Clearly, some of us might not be familiar with using social media like Twitter, Facebook, or LinkedIn, but many people are, and many people use these tools every day during their life. They can be very important to build a relationship with your clients, and even more in building a relationship with your potential clients, with those that you have not reached out to yet. You might look for advice in building a social media presence strategy, and you might wish to ask the younger colleagues in your practice maybe for advice, or to be responsible for developing the presence of your practice in the social media community. Or you might even think of asking your sons and daughters whether they want to lend you a hand in doing this.